As many of you know that are following my channel, my Kubota Sidekick has had a problem with gas and moisture getting in the oil since day one. I mean, I love the machine. It was beautiful, but the engine just had issues that nobody could solve. At first, they said it was my problem for short tripping it. These machines must be warmed up for 20 minutes to a half hour every time they're used. And there you can see what the oil came out of it the first couple times. It's like thin chocolate milk almost. It's a high percentage of gas. And there were some oil tests done and stuff, but it was in the dealer for 10 weeks last summer and actually returned to me in the same shape with no real solution to it other than run it longer. So I did run it longer and still having the same issue. And about a week ago, 2 weeks ago, I stopped at my dealer's to find out what was going on. Turned out he had two more just like it in there, he said, and he called Kubota in. And they decided to replace mine. Well, I was kind of a little leery to take another Sidekick. They offered another one. So dealer worked out a deal with me where I could pay the difference and upgrade to the diesel model that really shouldn't be a problem. They've been around for like 20 years, same engine and stuff. So this is the new replacement. It's one of the new RTV-Xs, and I've spent the last week switching things over. They let me keep both machines for a couple days, and here's a gizmo. I had to pull all the stickers off, everything off, all the, you know, the heavy duty struts for the plow and everything have to be switched over, the roof, the front window, the back window, the winch, all the wiring. So I have been really busy, and all this stuff was aftermarket that I added after. So, I had to do it. And there you can see stuff spread all over. And here's all the wires torn out and, you know, everything off of it now. So I had to switch the tires back because offsets were different between the machines. And it looks like I can't really use these good old tires that I bought because of the wheel offsets on the new one. And they did give me the ATV tires on this one, which the part number called for the turf, the worksite tires. But for some reason, I got ATV tires, and they told me that it would cost $350 to upgrade to the new style tire that I really wanted to try, which I decided it wasn't worth it. I just really got pissed over that. But anyhow, you know, there it is. The other Sidekick side by side, you can see there's a wider wheelbase on the Sidekick, and all the offsets on the wheels and stuff are different. So have to be careful with the RTV-Xs, but everything else is the same. You see, I just about identical roll cage frame, you know, a little different front grille and a little different front hood, but you know, pretty close to exact same size and about the same weight vehicles. Sidekick is fast, though, and this thing is a turtle. So, you know, that's about the biggest difference between them. But I've been, just about got everything switched over now. I'll show you in a second. And one thing I'm going to miss is the Sidekick had this piece of metal on the back, on the top of the bed, to finish that off. And this one, they put nothing. You just kind of got, like, the plastic back of the cab to slam stuff into. So I'm going to have to make something for back there. But, you know, they really cheaped out on that, I think. But anyhow, you don't need the seat belts or anything on the new one because it only goes, well, so far it'll only go 19 miles an hour, I figured out. But here's the Sidekick all stripped down, ready to go back. And, you know, one more look at the oil. You can see it's all turning to gray and up overfilled. And that's only with, like, about 3 more hours of runtime on it. And all that runtime, it was actually warmed up good, too. So definitely a problem with the engine. And apparently the problem with some other ones, too, now. But anyhow, gizmo's gone now. No more gizmo. And welcome, Slowpoke. Going to be calling this one Slowpoke just because it is. You can see everything switched over. Still have wiring to finish up. I have to buy some longer wires and stuff, but windshield fit, roof fit, back window, that whole plastic thing and grid I changed out with all my radio mounting and the heater and stuff. And that's really that's wonderful in the winter, keeping the window defogged when you're, you know, out there plowing. And I got the gun racks and the mirrors back on there and backup camera, got that back in there and stuff. And this one does have a real cushy seat, and it folds forward, and it's actually adjustable too, so my granddaughter can drive it. It's pretty neat. A nice cushy seat compared to the other one. And yes, it does have a power dump on it too for some reason. And again, it just came with those ATV tires. They're really crummy ones, I'll show you in the end. The thing just doesn't have enough power to spin them and clean them out. And there's all my strobe lights and everything back on there. So everything switched over now. A couple more wires to finish up. And oh yeah, down here I had to put an extension on the hitch on this one because the receiver itself is way back under the transmission there. You have to get on your knees to try to get one in there. And they're all too short to hook a ball trailer on once you put a ball in there. So that's another little thing. So I'll be doing an update as we go along. Give me a while to use it, and we'll see, you know, how it is and if anything goes wrong with it. And oh yeah, the best part about it is the gas pedal. It is so smooth when you take off. That Sidekick was so jerky, and it would just about throw you through the window half the time. Scared my granddaughter. And there it is, all switched over, and I just thought I'd do an update and let you know that, you know, this is finally solved. And there's the ATV tires. Just took me 2 tries to get up my back hill from the pond because they fill right up, and you can't spin them to clean them out like with the Sidekick. But I'll do something for tires, and, you know, I think it'll be good, and, you know, it's slow, but it shouldn't have any problems whatsoever from what I can see. Looks like it's going to be a, you know, perfect choice. I kind of wish the Sidekick had a better engine in it because I really did like the little bit of extra speed, but I wasn't going to take a chance again. So as I said, you know, I'll give it a while. I want to, you know, drive it for a while and, you know, see how everything is and, you know, getting used to it, stuff like that, and if there's anything I don't like about it. I mean, about the only thing so far are the tires and location of the trailer hitch and that one piece of, you know, metal missing on the back there. But everything else seems to be really solid and, you know, it does run great and, you know, just got to let it break in for a while. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.